that's that money talk. That's that money talk. Got a lot of fans, a lot of haters. We just let them talk. Cause they'll never face us to the paper. What you talking about? The earth we're really shaking with this craters that we throwing out, yeah. Came up in the game and gave it mouth to mouth.
Say some more. You got titty freedom. Block his number. You need me. I will every
human.
I promise.
What is up, you guys? It's your boy T-Rex back with another video. And today, we are talking about something that's been bringing a buzz the last, 4 days, and, I disagreed with their list, but, and a lot of our people did too, but I feel like I disagreed because, I disagreed a little less than everybody else, but, we're gonna be talking about the top 25 quarterbacks of all time, alright? And so, Bleacher Report made a list. And I'm pretty sure we've all seen this list. And basically, I didn't agree with the list just because I don't think Alex Smith and Carson Palmer belong on this list. I don't think they belong on this list. I think that's flawed. But most of the other people on this list have made my list. Like, I've decided to make a list of my own. And, most of the people on that list made this list. So, that's what we're going to be talking about today. And you know, if you're down with that, make sure you smash that like button, comment, subscribe, and let's get right into it. Oh, hit that notification bell, because you know, like, keep that night gang strong. So, let's go. So, let me tell you, this list took a long, long time, okay? I mean, 2 days, but, like, that's a really long time for a list. I mean, I don't know how long you would take for this list, but let me show you, like, this is my list, and I scratched all the names out, because, you know, I don't want to give any spoilers, but, like, do you see this, like, I have arrows, I've crossed out people, put other people, you know, I've crossed out numbers, numbered them differently, because it's just so difficult, it was so difficult for me to change this list, and I wasn't gonna make this video today, but I was like, you know, you might as well make it because, you know, you wait another day, you're just going to change another thing. And, you know, I'm trying to make this list perfect. It's never going to be perfect, you know, because there are so many guys that can arguably be up or down on this list. And, you know, it's hard to judge who the top quarterbacks are. But I feel like all of these quarterbacks fit in the top 25. They can just be numbered differently. So, like, if you have an argument about some of these quarterbacks, you know, comment about it and tell me about it. And, you know, we can talk about it. And I'm about to explain why I picked these quarterbacks. So let's get right into it. Honorable mention first, Joe Namath. Joe Namath was a quarterback for the Jets, won the Jets their first ever Super Bowl. And, you know, Joe, he was a poster child, like, for a QB. Like, who didn't want to be Joe Namath? Like, that man, he was a poster child. But his stats weren't that great. So, that's why he didn't make it on this top 25 list. And, you know, he's an honorable mention. And he is an honorable mention because he was on my list. I put him on my list. But, like I said, I changed my mind so many times that, you know, eventually I just took him off. I just feel like I had to. But, let's go. We're going to start from 25. So, number 25 is Warren Moon, okay? And Warren Moon had a spectacular career in the CFL. You know, he had 5 championships and just was killing the CFL. And he came to the NFL and had a great career as well. But he did not have as much success in the playoffs, which is why he is at number 25. He didn't have that much success in the playoffs. And, you know, his numbers aren't, you know, that high just because of how many years he played in the NFL. They are high for how many years he played. Trust me. He is 10th all-time in game-winning drives and in passing yards. So, like, those are high because he started his career in the CFL. And, you know, to be 10th all-time, not even starting your career in the NFL is amazing. 24, we got Phil Simms, okay? And Phil Simms, he won the Giants 2 Super Bowls, all right? And, you know, he almost didn't make this list either. But I cannot ignore that he put up one of the best Super Bowl performances ever. He was 22 for 25 in the Super Bowl. That's 88%. He had 268 yards, 3 touchdowns, zero interceptions, and about 151 passer rating. That's incredible. Like, that is one of, if not the best quarterback performance in the Super Bowl ever. That was Super Bowl 21, and they ended up, he ended up winning Super Bowl MVP, of course, against the Broncos and John Elway. But at number 23, I have Phillip Rivers. And Phillip Rivers, he's playing for the Chargers, who do not get a lot of attention at all. Like, the Chargers are probably the least, like, televised team in America as far as the NFL goes. And, you know, he's a great quarterback for that organization. He's 8th all-time in passing yards, and that's right now because he's still playing. So he's definitely going to go up on that list. And, you know, he's had 9 seasons with over 4,000 yards, which is incredible. And he hasn't missed a game since 2006. So, you know, I have to put Phillip Rivers on this list because, you know, he's a great quarterback. He's doing great things San Diego Chargers organization. Like, he's been a great quarterback for them. And then at number 22, I have Tony Romo. And I know some of you guys are going to disagree, but I have to put Tony Romo here because Tony Romo is statistically the best Cowboys quarterback ever. Like, if wins didn't matter, he would be the best Cowboys quarterback ever. If wins didn't matter. But wins do matter, and that's why he's at 22 and not higher. All right, because he didn't have any success in the playoffs. He did not have any success in the playoffs. Could not get to the big game. And he's definitely one of the best quarterbacks without a ring. Okay, and so let me tell you, he has the highest career passer rating of all retired quarterbacks. All right, and you know, he's tied for 5th all-time in pass completion rating. Like, he's very accurate. And I believe he's tied with Matt Ryan and I forgot the other person, actually. It's Matt Ryan and somebody else. Like, it's a 3-way tie. It might be Peyton Manning. It might be somebody else. I forgot. But he's tied for 5th all-time. And like I said, Tony Romo, he did great things for the Cowboys. It just, when it came to the playoffs, he couldn't succeed, and that's why he's only 22 on this list. Because if he could succeed in the playoffs, he would be way higher. And you know, if he gets one or two Super Bowls, he's higher than some of the other Cowboys quarterbacks that got on this list. So number 21 is Donovan Mcnabb, and Donovan Mcnabb was a beast for Philadelphia Eagles, and he's a beast quarterback. He's one of only 4 quarterbacks to have 30,000 passing yards, 200 passing touchdowns, over 20 rushing TDs, and 3,000 rushing yards. And the other 3 are also on this list. And he just missed the, you know, top 20 mark because he never won a ring. And, you know, that's unfortunate because, you know, he has the most playoff wins without a ring. And, yeah, it's unfortunate that he didn't win a ring. He was the first person to throw 30 touchdowns, more than 30 touchdowns, and less than 10 interceptions. So, you know, that he was a great quarterback for the Eagles. He just could never win a Super Bowl, and that's very unfortunate. But at number 20, we got Brett Favre, all right? Brett Favre was a beast, all right? He's a 3-time MVP. 1-time Super Bowl champ. The reason he's at number 20, to be honest with you, and not higher, is because he has the most interceptions and pick sixes of all time. Like, that's crazy. And he was a gunslinger, and that's not hard to believe, you know? Brett Favre, I feel, is a little underrated because that's the first thing I thought of because Brett Favre wasn't on my list, but that's first thing I thought of when I thought Brett Favre, interceptions. Like, that's crazy to think of it. That's the first thing I thought of when I thought of Brett Favre. Interceptions. But he's top five in passing yards, completions, and TDs. So you have to put him on this list because that's phenomenal. What he did with the Vikings and the Packers, he had great seasons there. And, you know, it was awesome. All right, at number 19, we got Bart Starr. And let me tell you, Bart Starr was a beast. He has the first ever Super Bowls. You know, that's an accomplishment on its own. You know, the first two with the Packers. And then his playoff record is 9-1. He's 90% in the playoffs. 90%. That's crazy. And then he's a four-time completion percentage and passing rating leader. So, you know, during his time, he was one of the best quarterbacks in the league and one of the most accurate as well. And then, and number 18, we got Jim Kelly. And Jim Kelly made it to four Super Bowls with the Buffalo Bills, all right? But unfortunately, he was unable to win any of them, and that's why he's only number 18. He wins two or three of those, he's higher up on this list. Because he had a very good, he was very good in the playoffs. Like, in the playoffs and in the regular season. Just when it came to the Super Bowl, he just couldn't perform. And, you know, that's why he's at 18 on his list. And originally, I had him higher on my list. But I said I can't just because, you know, his performances in the Super Bowl and his inability to win a ring. I have to put him lower on this list. And there are the guys that are over him, I feel they've done better. And the 17th person on my list is Russell Wilson. He's young, but I thought about it, and he deserves to be on this list. He already has a Super Bowl, and he has the second highest passer rating in the NFL behind one person who is right above him. And he averaged 545 rushing yards. He averages 545 rushing yards a season. And while doing that, he also throws for 3,000 passing, at least 3,000 passing yards a season and 20 passing touchdowns. That's phenomenal. And Russell Wilson, if you watch him, he makes phenomenal plays. His ability to escape the pocket and, you know, make accurate throws down the field is amazing. And it's like magic watching him create plays that are broken. You know, that's when I think of Russell Wilson, that's what I think of immediately. That's what I think of. And then at number 16, we got Aaron Rodgers, all right? And you could argue Aaron Rodgers could be higher on his list, but I couldn't. And I will say that by the end of his career, he probably will be higher on this list. But personally, I couldn't see him going higher on his list, and I couldn't put him higher on his list. But Aaron Rodgers, he has one Super Bowl, two-time MVP. He has the best career passing rating of everyone, all time. And he has the best season passer rating as well. But, you know, when I think of Aaron Rodgers, you know, I just think of... I see Aaron Rodgers as an overrated quarterback in our game today. When I hear Aaron Rodgers' names, all I hear is these things that... The things that could have happened if he had this. Like, if he was healthy... And it seems like he's never healthy. That's what makes me angry, because it's like if he was healthy, they would have won this game. It's like he's playing in the game, though. So, like, that shouldn't be an excuse. And, you know, I guess this is just personal because I don't like Aaron Rodgers. But, you know, I put him at 16. I just don't see him. First of all, I just don't see him above anybody else on this list. And I don't know. You could argue that he belongs higher on this list. I'll listen to that argument, but I don't think I would put him higher on this list. So, that was part one of the video. And, you know, I made this into two parts because the original take without any edits was 40 minutes. So, I was like, it's probably going to be long. But this was part one of the video. If you enjoyed, smash that like button, comment, subscribe, hit that notification button, and share with everybody you know. And part two will be out tomorrow, so be ready for it, and I'll see you for now, and so peace.
Cause I talk like this and my ass fat, they be saying Iggy trying to act black, hating broke hoes get laughed at, all they do is cap like snapbacks. He hit me up, he said he having flashbacks, you my ex for a reason, I don't backtrack. Give me 50 feet, bitch, back. I got time today, I'm finna clap back.